Hi, and welcome to this beginner's course on regular expressions, also known as RegEx. This knowledge is a must for any developer or IT professional. Today, RegEx support is included in all large programming languages. Although there might be some differences from language to language, the basics are the same, and this is what we are going to look at today. Some typical use cases are input validation, string parsing, search and replace text, data mapping, syntax highlighting, and there are many others. Regular expressions usually consist of two parts: character literal, which just represent themselves, so in place English character A would match character A. The other part are metacharacters, which help you create matching patterns, and the part that you want to master. In this course, we will go through all of these one by one, and in the end, we will combine them in a couple of exercises to see their true power. After this course, you will understand each and one and be able to combine them. Here you can see the list of all the basic characters used to create regular expressions. Note, the power in regular expression is usually seen first when you combine character literals with metacharacters to create complex expressions for pattern matching. In this course, I will many times be using them one by one, and it will sometimes seem pointless to use them in that way, but I will only do this so you can learn the basics. So the examples that you will see in the start of the course is not something you would do in real life. I will demonstrate their full power at the end of the course by combining them to create more complex expressions, and by then you will be able to read complex expressions and even build them yourself. Also, the metacharacters and expressions that I am going to use during this course are the basic ones available in all large programming languages, such as PHP, JavaScript, Perl, Python, Java, and so on. So all the examples that I'm going to show during this course should work the same no matter what language you're using. Still, you should understand that I'm not going to show all the RegEx features, but I will show you the basic ones that are shared among most of the languages. Also, once you understand the basics, learning about the additional features a specific language is supporting will be quite easy. Follow along this course, I will recommend that you also use the regex101.com website, as it is one of the best websites when it comes to trying out and testing your regular expression. Okay, so back to basics. As I said earlier, literal characters match themselves, so that is simple. As you can see, characters A, B, C, 1, 2, 3 match themselves. Now let's look at how we can use metacharacters for matching of some digits. We have a simple string here. The backslash D metacharacter represents any digit from 0 to 9. The backslash indicates that it is a metacharacter and not a simple D character. If I add one more, you can see that we now match one more digit, and by adding more, we can also match all of them. Now, if I instead use the uppercase, I will match any character that's not a digit. So I can use uppercase D to replace all letters and get a match here. The next metacharacter is the one most powerful, and it will match anything. This is the dot. In our previous example, How would we use the dot to match the string? Well, we just replace everything with dots. Note, later you will learn how to do this much more efficiently. For now, let's continue. Let's match ABC dot. So that was easy. But what if we change the dot to D? It still matches. Well, this is because here the dot is a meta character that will match any character. And this is not what we want. We want to only match ABC dot. To get the dot character instead of meta character, we need to escape the dot with backslash. And now we're matching the dot character. You can see that the D is no longer matched. We will come back to the dot later throughout this course. For now, let's continue. The next meta character is matching of specific characters. This is done by using the square brackets. Let me illustrate. Let's say we would like to match get, mat, net, but not rat, pet, tat. Also, let's add a modifier g, which means it should continue even when first match is found. Later in the course, I will talk more about modifiers. You can see that they all share A and T at the end. We would like to match C, M and N, but not R, P and T. This is where matching of only specific characters comes in. This is done by using square brackets with character I would like to match. So in this case, it will be C, M, N. And you can see how we match all three. If I add R, now you can see that even rat is included in the match. Let me remove R. Now, what if I want to match anything that ends on A and T, but exclude cat, mat, and net instead? Well, to exclude specific characters, you also use square brackets, but you can also add the caret. Now, when we add the caret, this will match any string with length of 3 ending with at. For example, we can add uat and xat, and they are also matched. But what if we want to include any string that ends with AT and starts with any sequential character from A to Z? Well, there is a simple way to do that by using the hyphen to indicate the range. As you can see, now we match all strings but not 5AT. Of course, if we add the caret, we will match all other characters. So earlier we learned that you can match any digit with backslash d, but can we do that using square brackets and hyphen? Sure, and it is easy. We just add 0-9, and now it will match any digit. As you can see, it matching 5 here. Now, let's say we would like to match Anna, Bia and Zia, but we would like to exclude Anna, Bia and Tia starting with a lowercase. Well, this should not be difficult. We want to start with any uppercase character from A to C, and this we we can do by using square brackets and the hyphen. Then we would like to include N and I, and in the end we would have the literal character A, as they all end with A. And that is it. Now, what if we also like to include the three other strings? Well, one easy way to do this is to add A, B, and T, like this. And now we match all of them, as you can see. Now we will learn about an expression similar to the dot, where any character is included. But in this case, it does not match any character, but instead matches any alphanumeric character. This expression is the backslash W. So, how do we define an alphanumeric character? Well, it includes any character in the range uppercase A to uppercase Z, lowercase a to lowercase z, and underscore. If we use our knowledge from previous lesson, we can notice that any alphanumeric character also can be written with square brackets, uppercase e a to uppercase z, lowercase a to lowercase z, and underscore. But as alphanumeric is used very often, we do not need to use this expression. Instead, we can use backslash W. So let's take a simple example. How do we match hello 123 just by using alphanumeric expression? Well, it is easier than you think. All you need to do is add a couple of backslash W's and you will get the match, as backslash W will match both letters and digits. We will come back to alphanumeric expression later in this course, but for now, let's continue. Now we will move to repetitions. Earlier, when we matched digits, we would do something like this. We would match each digit with backslash D. Of course, this is not really useful. And of course, there is a way to say exactly how many digits you would like to match. This is done by using the curly braces. In this case, we have 7 digits. Now you can see that we are matching 7 digits exactly. But you can also specify the range for the repetition. So now, if you only have 4 digits, there will be no match. Now let's do a simple exercise. Let's put the G flag back. We would like to match space with 3 and 4 A's. But not with 2 A's. So we have S and P. Then we have A that is repeating 3 or 4 times, and in the end we have CE. And this is our regular expression. When it comes to repetition, there are 2 meta characters that are used everywhere. These are the star and the plus metacharacters. Star is for any number of repetitions, and plus stands for at least one repetition. Let's remove the G flag. Let's take previous example where we had some digits. We can match this with either the star or plus, like this. They both work. The difference is that star will work if the string is empty even. But the plus will not, because it needs at least one repetition. So let's look at an example. First, add the G flag. Now, let's match AAABBC and AABBBCC, but we would like to skip AB. We have two or more A's, we have two or more B's, and we have one or more C's. Well, this is just one way to do this. There are more accurate ways to do this, and one way is by using curly brackets. I will let you try to figure it out. It is not difficult. Now, what if you only want to match 0 or 1 of the preceding character? So, this was the first part of our regular expressions for beginners course. If you liked it and would like to watch the rest, you can do so at virtualcallback.com. You can find the direct link in the description. Please like and subscribe. We will be creating similar courses in the future.